Hello and welcome to Kids Can Sunday School. I'm Eden.
And I'm Sarah.
And we have started a new month, and that means a new faith word and a new memory verse.
How exciting! You can pick. What are we doing first? Faith word, memory verse, what's it gonna be?
I choose faith word.
Awesome. So what is our new faith word?
This month, our faith word is love.
Aww. Love.
I think this is a great follow-up to last month's word, share. Our whole job is to reach out and share God's love with people. This month, our word love reminds us of the big job God has given us, and it also helps us remember that we need to put our faith into action by looking for ways to show love. Hmm. Let's check out our wonder questions, because they have a little bit to do with our faith word this month.
Yes, they do.
What does love mean?
Hmm.
How do you show love? How do leaders show love?
Ooh, that's a big question, and I like it.
Big question. Our memory verse today is from Romans 12, verse 10a. Love each other like the members of your family. Think about your family. The love you have for your family is different from other kinds of loves. Your family sees and celebrates you at your best. One time, I got to represent my school at the charter school spelling bee. My family came and supported me. It was a really special day. They were proud of me, and I was happy they came to watch me. Your family also sees you and walks through the worst with you. Mm-hmm. Like when you have a bad day and feel grumpy and say mean things. You know, like you don't want to get up.
Oh, that never happens with you.
That has happened in my family. Even though sometimes we hurt each other's feelings, when that happens, we always forgive each other. And we always love each other. The book of Romans was written by Paul to the church in Rome to give them special instructions. Our verse this month is from that book. He was writing about how the people of the church should treat each other. It's telling us to love each other like we love our own family.
Mm-hmm.
As we work on this verse, on our verse this month, I have a special challenge for you. Dum-dum-dum. Challenge time.
Challenge time. Whoop, whoop.
Look for a way to let someone in our church know they are loved.
Ooh, I can't wait to hear what you guys come up with to let the people of the church know that they are loved. You got a whole month to figure something out and to take Eden on in her challenge. So that's very exciting to me. I can't wait to hear about it. But in the meantime, we're going to dig into our story for today. We're going to read from the book of Acts. We've been reading from the book of Acts for a while now, and we're going to keep it up in the book of Acts. And we're going to look at a passage that happened after our one from last week where the believers were all together sharing. We're going to look at a time when the church was growing stronger and getting bigger, and we're going to see what happened when the leaders came across a time where they had a difficult time taking care of everything. So we're going to check it out. Eden, where are you reading from today?
Today we're reading from my mom's digital Bible app on her phone. And today we are reading from Acts 6 verses 1 through 7 in case any of you guys want to read along with us.
Yep.
Selection of seven to serve. About that time, while the number of disciples continued to increase, a complaint arose. Greek-speaking disciples accused the
Aramaic-speaking
disciples because their widows were being overlooked in the daily food service. The 12 called a meeting of all the disciples and said, "It isn't right for us to set aside proclamation of God's word in order to serve tables. Brothers and sisters, carefully choose seven well-respected men from among you. They must be well-respected and endowed by the Spirit with exceptional wisdom. We will put them in charge of this concern. As for us, we will devote ourselves to prayer and the service of proclaiming the word." This proposal pleased the entire community. They selected Stephen, a man endowed by the Holy Spirit with exceptional faith. Philip,
Prochorus,
Nicanor, Timon,
Parmenius,
and Nicholas from Antioch. a convert to Judaism. The community presented these seven to the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. God's word continued to grow. The number of disciples in Jerusalem increased significantly. Even a large group of priests embraced faith.
Thank you, Eden.
You're welcome.
There were some hard names in that passage, huh?
Yeah.
Aren't you glad your name is Eden and not Prochorus?
Yeah.
We're going to dig right into our passage today. Our passage starts with the identification of a problem. Did you pick on what the problem was?
I did.
What was it?
The widows were not being served in the daily food service.
Yeah, some of the widows felt like they were being overlooked. So one of the things that the early church did was take care of the widows. We read last week about how they were together all the time. They shared everything. They took care of each other. One of the things they shared was food. Well, these widows felt like they weren't getting their share of food. And so instead of just complain and grumble and talk about it and not do anything about it, they brought their concern to the disciples. And this brought a bigger problem to the surface. The disciples were trying to teach all the people they could about Jesus. And that's why the church was growing, because they were doing a really good job with that. They were telling a lot of people about the good news of Jesus. But what happened was there was some other things that they were trying to take care of too, and they were starting to get overwhelmed. And this is when they did something really brave, something anyway that I think was really brave.
Can I say it?
Yeah, what did they do, Eden?
They asked for help.
Yeah, they kind of assessed the situation and they said, we need help here. So sometimes, I don't know about you guys, but for me, it's hard to ask for help. I get embarrassed when I need help. I think sometimes I get a little prideful about asking for help. I think that I'm the only one that can do something the way that I want it done. Sometimes I think other people will think less of me if I have to ask for help, or maybe they won't think that I'm very smart if I have to ask for help. There are all kinds of reasons why people avoid asking for help. But every time I ask for help, do you want to know what? Two things happen. The first thing is that most of the time, the person that I ask for help is not only willing to help, but they've been waiting to be asked to help. So they've been waiting for a time where someone would ask them to do something that they could use the gifts and talents that God gave them. And then the second thing that happens is not only do I feel less overwhelmed, but I feel really blessed and happy because someone else is able to use the gifts that God gave them to serve others. As I thought about our passage and I thought about our faith word for this month, love, I think there's a definite connection. The passage we read today is about finding ways to put love into action, if we really boil it down. Because they found a problem, we just identified it. It's about the widows feeling they were being treated fairly. And instead of ignoring it, they took care of it in a way that showed love to the widows, and it plugged people in to serve using the gifts and talents that God gave them. Now, the people that were in charge of things, they wanted to make sure all the stuff was getting done, all the day-to-day work was getting done, but they also really wanted to be able to go out and tell people about Jesus. They decided the best thing that they could do, the most wise choice that they could make, was to get some people to help them, because they couldn't do both. They were at a point where there were just too many people. They just couldn't do both. So they picked, how many people did they pick, Eden, to help them?
Seven.
So they picked seven people who loved God and who were filled with the Holy Spirit to help them get the things done that needed to get done every day. So these guys were able to help people by taking care of all the stuff that maybe wasn't the most glamorous parts of the job, but it was stuff that needed to get done so the church would continue to grow and thrive and be healthy. So when the leaders of the church asked for help, they were putting the faith word of the month, love, into action. They were showing love by letting other people unlock their gifts and talents and put them to use instead of just trying to do everything themselves and getting burned out and getting tired. So they were showing great love when they asked for help. And what about us, guys? What can we learn We can learn a couple things. We can learn, number one, that it's okay and it's even good to ask for help. It actually shows love when we ask for help and include people and allow them to do the things that they're good at. Another takeaway we can learn from this is that we need to be looking for ways to show love all the time. If the disciples were just too caught up in the problem and not looking for ways to show love consistently, they wouldn't be able to solve the problem. We always need to be back looking for ways to be showing love. And that brings us back to our wonder questions. How do you show love? We challenged you guys earlier. We want you guys to keep thinking about that challenge. We want you to find ways to do that this week and this month. We want you guys to be consistently finding ways to show love to our church, to your families, to your neighbors, to your school friends, to your teachers, to everyone you come in contact with, because that's what God's about. He's about letting people know that He loves them through His people. And that's us, guys. We're His people. So we get to do that. But it's not always easy. So we're going to ask Jesus to help us to do that. So let's pray. God, thank you so much that you have given us your word. We thank you for the braveness of the church leaders to be willing to ask for help, God. And we thank you that by doing that, other people were able to step up and use the gifts and talents that you gave them. So not only were the disciples showing great love, but we were also seeing help and service put into action, God. And that's just a picture of who you are and what you want us to be doing. So we pray that you'll help us to follow their example. We pray that we'll be able to ask for help when we need it. And we also pray that we'll be able to show love always, God. And we ask this in Jesus' name, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. That's all for us today. Be sure to check out our craft video and let us know what you think about our wonder questions by emailing christianed@pfumc.org or posting them on the Kids Camp Facebook page. Have a great week. We'll see you next time. Bye.